In this video, I will be looking at using subroutines in CRBasic. Subroutines are a convenient way to create a section of code once, but use it in multiple locations throughout a program. An added benefit of this is whenever I need to make a change to the code, I only need to do it in one spot, and it helps me keep the size of my program down. That means fewer lines of code to read through, understand, and troubleshoot down the road. I also like to use subroutines to compartmentalize a piece of code, and that way I can easily copy and paste it from one program to the next. I will often create a subroutine for a specific sensor as part of a project, and then reuse that subroutine for other programs and other projects. Starting with the program that I've been working with that has the SDI-12 water level measurement in it every 15 minutes, I'm going to scroll down to just below the data table section. There are some comments here that are left over from the template that I started with initially. These let me know that I can define a subroutine here. If I do, I need to use the sub and end sub instructions. The next thing I want to do is give a name to the subroutine. I'm going to call it measure stage. As the name implies, I'm going to use this subroutine to make my stage measurements, which I'm currently doing at two separate locations in the program. Once in the main scan, and then again in the slow sequence. I'm going to take the SDI-12 recorder from the main scan, cut it out, and paste it into my subroutine. And then in the slow sequence, I will delete the SDI-12 recorder instruction. If I do a compile check, the program compiles, but it lets me know my declared measure stage subroutine is not being used anywhere. I will use the call instruction to call the subroutine named measure stage. Now, if I had multiple subroutines defined in the program, their names would show up here as well. I would select the one I needed from the list. In this example, I just have one subroutine. I select it, insert it, and then copy and paste that call instruction into my slow sequence. What I've done is replace those individual SDI-12 recorder instructions with calls to a subroutine that includes the same SDI-12 recorder instruction. The nice thing about this is if I ever need to change the address I'm using for the sensor, or maybe the command, I only need to do it in this one location, whereas before I would have needed to remember to do it in multiple locations. The next thing I want to do is add some retries to the SDI-12 measurement. Retries are helpful because they increase the ability to get valid measurements if a sensor occasionally needs a slightly longer response time. The easiest way to add retries is to put the SDI-12 recorder instruction inside of a do loop. I use the do and loop instructions. But if I leave it like this, the first time the subroutine is called, the data logger will get stuck in this do loop and continue to execute this SDI-12 instruction as fast as it can without ever exiting the loop. To resolve this, I'm going to use the exit do instruction to exit the do loop whenever a valid response from the sensor is returned. I will type, if stage does not equal NaN, then exit do. In other words, if the sensor responds correctly and NaN is not returned, then there's no need to retry it, so exit the loop. But what happens if NaN is returned? Right now, if the sensor does not respond, which results in a NaN, the data logger will again get stuck in this do loop. I need to limit the number of times it retries. To do that, I'm going to add a retries variable to the subroutine and then use the while instruction. I'm going to add, while retries is greater than 0, and then I will come up here to my sub instruction, and in parentheses, I'm going to add retries as long. What I'm doing here is creating a variable called retries, and I'm also creating an argument for this subroutine. Think of the argument as a parameter for this subroutine. Now the program says, if retries is greater than 0, continue to loop through this section of code. Notice the retries variable is green in the editor, and if I right-click on it, I see that it has an L for local, meaning that I can only use this variable in the subroutine where I defined it. I'm going to add retries minus equals 1. Every time the data logger loops through this section of code, it will decrease retries by 1. Eventually, it will decrease it to 0 and the loop will be exited. This section of code says if I get a valid response or use up all my retries, then exit this loop. Now if I try to do a compile, I get an error letting me know there's a call argument required. When I created this variable, I created an argument for the subroutine, and now I need to define a value for this argument in the subroutine call statements. I'm going to scroll to my call in the main scan. I'm going to say in parentheses 5. What I'm doing is providing a value for this retries variable. Every time I call it in this place in the program, I'm going to use the number 5 for my retries. Similarly, I can scroll to the slow sequence, and in this case, I'm not so worried about the number of retries because this is real-time data. I want it to be responsive. That way, if there's an error while I'm watching it, I can investigate it right away. For this call argument, I'm going to use a value of 1, meaning only one retry will occur. This is a great example of how using a subroutine with arguments allows a lot of flexibility in a program because you can use different values for the argument in different places in the program. Now I have a program with a subroutine that allows me to make changes to the code easily in one location. And the program is more robust because I've added a customized number of retries at different locations in the program.